However much they try to deny it, Barcelona have a problem with Antoine Griezmann. Individually, La Liga's restart has generally been profitable for Barca's forwards. Martin Braithwaite scored his first goal for the club in a good performance at Mallorca. Similarly, Ansu Fati netted an excellent opener to cap a strong showing against Leganés. Luis Suarez has eased back into action after injury, and Lionel Messi is still Lionel Messi. But from Griezmann, there has been practically nothing. The Frenchman's performance against Leganés on Tuesday night was very worrying. Despite playing the full 90 minutes, he barely had any impact. And this was in a game where Barca had 75% of possession and spent the majority of the time trying to pick their way through the opposing defence. Even in that supposedly beneficial environment for a forward, Griezmann was virtually anonymous. His struggles look even worse when you compare his contribution of 22 touches in 90 minutes with his attacking teammates, all of whom were far greater protagonists than Griezmann. It wasn't only the game against Leganés on Tuesday. Griezmann was similarly invisible in his first game back at Mallorca on Saturday night. Griezmann certainly can't complain that he hasn't been given sufficient opportunities with his new club this season. Behind Gerard Piqué, he has spent more time on the pitch than any other outfield player, but still, he's not fitting in. Why? Well, a lot has been said about the lack of connection between Griezmann and his captain, and clearly the team's most important player, Messi. And on recent evidence, it is a serious problem. Against Leganés on Tuesday, Messi made 61 passes to 12 different teammates, but his total number of passes to Griezmann was zero. Griezmann, meanwhile, made just one pass to Messi. Only one direct connection between the team's two main forwards over the full 90 minutes of a game they dominated? That is a massive worry. Messi's apparent disinterest in playing with Griezmann was summed up by a passage of play in the second half, shortly after Suarez has entered the action. Messi had possession in midfield, and Griezmann made a run in behind the Leganés defence. Clearly, Messi has the ability to cut out the defence by lofting a pass into the stride of Griezmann's run. We've seen him do this hundreds of times. But he only had eyes for his best buddy Suarez, completely ignoring Griezmann's dangerous run, leaving the Frenchman frustrated once again. Sometimes when it rains, it pours, and Griezmann's frustration was compounded by the fact that he did actually score against Leganés, but had it ruled out offside against Nelson Semedo in the build-up. It's surely not coincidental that by far Griezmann's best game for the club against Real Betis back at the start of the season came when Messi was absent. Rather than getting better, as it would be reasonable to expect, Griezmann's lack of connection with his teammates, especially Messi, appears to be getting worse. The stats from his last 10 appearances are dismal, and it's easy to argue that he's not worth a place in the team. Barca's next game is a huge one, away at third place Sevilla on Friday night. For various reasons, manager Quique Setién only has one guaranteed starter for his forward line, Messi. If he is physically ready, Suarez will certainly start alongside the skipper. And the fact that he was fully rested from Tuesday's game against Leganés suggests that Braithwaite may well be in Setién's mind to start at Sevilla. However, Suarez is maybe not yet ready to start such a high-intensity game after just two brief substitute appearances in 5 months. So perhaps Fati's sharp showing against Leganés will be rewarded with another start. There may even be a starting spot in an advanced role for Arturo Vidal, whose dynamic displays have really caught the eye since the restart. But Griezmann? Well, the main argument in his favour is that he remains very diligent defensively, and his willingness to track back would be valuable against a Sevilla team that relies on attacking width, especially from right-back Jesús Navas. So, he may start on Friday night. But the main reason for picking a 120 million World Cup winning forward is because he defends well? That's not good. Not good at all.